Hello students, welcome to EPG Pathshala. I am Professor Panchapakeshan from the University of Delhi. Today we are going to discuss about the module Dirac field quantization and hole theory. This is part of the paper on radiation theory in the course on physics. After studying this module, you should be able to understand the projection operators for positive and negative energies, helicity, chirality, and spin. You should be able to understand the use of Pauli principle to tackle the problem of negative energy states, which leads to the hole theory. You should learn to write the Lagrangian for the Dirac field. You should learn to Fourier decompose the Dirac field and quantize it. And you should understand that the Fermi field requires anti-commutation relation for quantization. You should learn that the quantization takes one to a many-particle ground state or vacuum by filling up all the negative energy states. The holes in negative energy states behave like antiparticles or positrons. You should understand that particle-antiparticle pair creation in ground state or vacuum brings in a revolutionary new feature into quantum physics. It completely changes the nature of the vacuum. The Dirac equation for the electron, along with spinners and the gamma matrices, was introduced in the last module. In this module, we first study projection operators in section 3, which helps us to project out specific spin states or specific energy states. They help us to use the completeness relation in our calculations. Completeness relation involves sum over all the states of the electron. Inclusion of projection operators allows the sum over all the states and allows use of completeness relation. We study the projection operators for energy, spin, helicity, and chirality. We then consider the Lagrangian for the electron, which leads us to the Dirac equation as its equation of motion in section 4. This enables us to identify the canonical momenta and proceed to quantization. As briefly mentioned in module 3, for spin half particles obeying Fermi-Dirac statistics, anti-commutators, not commutators, have to be used. This was discovered by Dirac for the first time when he studied the quantum field theory of the electron and gave the Dirac theory of radiation in 1927. This enables, as we shall see, the solution of the problem posed by solutions of electron with negative energies. Dirac postulated that all negative energy states are filled up in the vacuum or the ground state. A hole is a vacancy created by removal of one negative energy electron, and then it behaves like a positron or an antiparticle of electron. Hole theory, which thus gave a dynamic ground state or vacuum to the field theories, field theoretic Lagrangian, describes the vacuum as a dynamical object with constant creation and annihilation of particles and antiparticle pairs. We discuss the hole theory in section 5 before proceeding to the Fourier decomposition of the plane waves in section 6. First, we talk about projection operators. These operators project out from a given solution a specified required solution, like a positive energy spin-up solution. They are very useful in actual calculation. Positive and negative energy states. We can use the projection operator capital lambda plus or minus equal to plus or minus p slash plus m divided by 2m for projecting out positive and negative energy solutions respectively. These operators satisfy the requirement that their squares are same as themselves, namely capital lambda plus whole squared is equal to lambda plus, capital lambda minus whole squared is equal to lambda minus, and in addition, they are orthogonal. So lambda plus into lambda minus is equal to lambda minus into lambda plus is equal to 0, and lambda plus lambda minus is equal to 1. To check these relations, we notice that for any two 4 vectors a and b, we have a slash b slash plus b slash a slash is equal to a mu into gamma mu into b nu into gamma nu plus b nu gamma nu a mu gamma mu, which is equal to a mu b nu anticommutator of gamma mu gamma nu, which is equal to a mu b nu into twice g mu nu, or which is equal to twice a dot b. This is the 4 vector product, where a is equal to b, a slash into a slash becomes a squared. Hence, starting with equation 3.1, we have lambda plus whole squared is equal to p squared plus m squared plus twice mp slash, which is equal to 4m squared, which can be written as ep squared minus p squared plus m squared plus twice mp slash divided by 4m squared, which is equal to twice m squared plus twice mp slash divided by 4m squared, which is again lambda plus. The other relation in equation 3.2 can be proved in the same way. All the other relations can be proved in the same way. Using the Dirac equation in the form shown in the previous module, namely p slash minus m operating on us is equal to 0 and p slash plus m operating on vs as a function of momentum is equal to 0, we find lambda plus operating on us as a function of p is equal to p slash plus m by 2m into us, which is equal to p slash minus m plus 2m over 2m into usp, which is equal to 0 plus usp, which is equal to usp. Similarly, lambda minus operating on vsp will give us vsp, and lambda minus operating on usp will give me 0, and lambda minus operating on the vs, of course, gave the vsp. In the same way, using equations conjugate to equation 3.5, one can show that us bar into lambda plus is equal to us bar, and vs bar into lambda minus is equal to vs bar, and vs bar lambda plus as well as us bar lambda minus give us 0 values. Though we have not written it specifically, lambda plus minus is also a function of the momentum p. The next operator is the helicity operator. The spin of the Dirac electron, like any fermion, when measured along any particular direction, can be either plus or minus in units of h cross by 2. The special direction can be taken along the motion of the electron, except in the rest frame of the electron. The spin along the direction of motion is called helicity. The helicity projection operators project out states of positive and negative helicities. We have seen that half of sigma mu nu is the spin operator for the electron. We define a 3 vector sigma, which is equal to, has 3 components, sigma 2, 3, sigma 3, 1, and sigma 1, 2, and take its projection along the direction of motion of the electron. So sigma p, the projection, is equal to sigma dot p divided by p, which is eigenvalues plus 1 or minus 1. The helicity projection operator is defined by capital pi plus or minus function of momentum p is equal to half of 1 plus or minus sigma of p. They obey the properties of the projection operators, namely pi plus minus whole squared is equal to pi plus minus, pi plus into pi minus into pi plus, both vanish, and pi plus pi minus is equal to 1. We can also show that for any solution of Dirac equation, the energy and helicity projection operators commute, namely lambda plus and pi plus minus, as well as lambda minus and pi plus minus, both vanish. Their commutators both vanish. That shows they can both be valid for one given solution. The solution u plus minus p and v plus minus p are also helicity eigenstates, besides being energy and spin eigenstates. When in z direction, like 514 or 515 of module 14. Further, sigma p operating on USP is S times USP. Sigma p operating on VS is equal to minus S times VSP with S equal to plus or minus for three momentum in the Z direction. For any other direction of momentum, linear combination of U spinners and V spinners will satisfy equation 314. The projection operators are also independent of the representations of gamma matrices of Dirac equation. Next, we take the chirality projection operator. In general, any operator is square is identity can be used to construct a projection operator. If L is an operator such that L squared is equal to 1, we can define two operators, M plus, which is half into 1 plus L, and M minus, which is half into 1 minus L. They satisfy all the properties of projection operators, like equation 312. Now, gamma phi also squares to identity. So, we can use gamma phi to construct another pair of projection operators, namely, half into 1 minus gamma phi and half into 1 plus gamma phi. Half into 1 minus gamma phi is denoted by L, and half into 1 plus gamma phi is denoted by R. They are called the chirality projection operators. They are closely related to the helicity projection operators, and the limit in the limit M approaching 0, they become the same. Spin projection operators. They are needed for particles at rest to project spin states for a spatial direction denoted by unit 3 vector S cap. We first define a 4 vector N mu whose components are defined by N0 is equal to P vector dot S cap divided by M. And N, the three components, are S cap plus P dot S cap into P divided by M into E plus M, where EP denotes the four momentum of the particle of mass M. N mu in equation 316 has been constructed to satisfy product of P mu into N mu, or the P mu N mu contracted is equal to zero. And n mu is equal to minus 1. Thus, p mu n mu, if you work it out, vanishes. One can show similarly, n mu is minus 1. So, gamma phi n slash whole squared will be gamma phi n mu gamma mu into gamma phi n mu gamma mu, which is equal to minus n mu gamma mu gamma nu, which is equal to minus n mu gamma nu gamma mu, where we've just used the anti-commutation property, which is equal to minus n mu into twice g mu nu, which is equal to minus n mu, which is equal to plus 1. Hence, the required projection operators for the spin are p with spin up is equal to half of 1 plus gamma phi n slash, and p with spin down is half of 1 minus gamma phi n slash. Let us check for the case when unit 3 vector S cap is along the X direction, that is S cap has the components 1, 0, 0. In the rest frame of the particle, N0 is equal to 0 and N is equal to S cap. So N1 is equal to 1, N2 and N3 are 0. Hence N mu is equal to 0, 1, 0, 0 and N slash is equal to gamma 1. So gamma phi of N slash is I gamma naught gamma 1, gamma 2, gamma 3 into minus gamma 1. And when you carry it out, it gives you I simplified I gamma naught gamma 2 gamma 3, which is equal to gamma naught into sigma 1. Remember that gamma 1 squared is minus 1. This commutes with sigma 1, and we have a well-defined component along the X direction. Now we go to the Lagrangian for the Dirac field. Dirac equation can be derived from the Lagrangian. Lagrangian script L is equal to psi bar I d slash minus m psi, where written out fully, the Lagrangian is psi bar alpha multiplied by I into gamma mu alpha beta into d mu minus m delta alpha beta into psi beta. We can treat psi, where the alpha beta are the spinner indices. We can treat psi and psi bar or psi dagger as independent. We can take either psi bar or psi dagger as independent. Equation of motion. Euler-Lagrange equation for psi bar is given by d mu of dd of d mu psi bar alpha of the Lagrangian. And this is equal on the right hand side to dd psi bar alpha of the Lagrangian. As Lagrangian does not contain derivative of psi bar, the left-hand side is zero, so we get I gamma mu d mu minus m into psi x is equal to zero, which is the Dirac equation obtained in the previous module, which we wrote as I d slash minus m operating on psi is equal to zero. While in classical theory, the Lagrangian is real, in quantum field theory, it should be Hermitian, but the Dirac Lagrangian is not Hermitian. I psi bar gamma mu d mu psi dagger is equal to minus psi d mu psi dagger gamma mu dagger gamma c into psi, gamma naught into psi. Minus I, which is gives us minus I d mu psi bar into gamma mu psi. L prime, the Lagrangian, which is equal to half psi bar gamma mu d mu psi minus I by 2 d mu psi bar gamma mu psi minus m psi bar psi. And this differs from equation 4.1 by a total divergence, which is d mu of total divergence of I by 2 psi bar gamma mu psi. As Lagrangian differing by total divergence are equivalent, we can continue using equation 4.1. Conserved current. This Lagrangian is invariant under the transformation psi going to exponential minus iq theta psi, giving the Noether current j mu equal to d mu of psi of the Lagrangian multiplied by delta psi, with delta psi equal to minus iq psi. So we have j mu, the conserved current, as q into psi bar gamma mu psi. The conserved charge is given by capital Q, which is equal to q integrated over d cubed x of psi bar gamma naught psi, or which is q integrated over psi dagger psi d cubed x. This is the charge. Hole theory. Dirac solved the problem of negative energies by making bold use of the Pauli exclusion principle to fill up all the negative energy states of the electron. So the ground state or vacuum has an infinite number of electrons filling up the negative energy state. The positive energy region is empty. So we can show E equal to zero, and above the line E equals plus mc squared, and below the line E equal to minus mc squared. All the negative energy states are below equal to minus mc squared in the diagram, and all the negative energy region is filled up, and the positive energy region is empty. The negative energy regions are all filled up. Dirac also discovered that he had to use anticommutators for spin-half wave functions and particle operators. The theory was transformed from a single particle to many particles, and from particles of negative charge to particles of both charges, one called a particle and another called an antiparticle. First, Dirac thought that the antiparticles may be the proton, but a different mass created a big problem. Soon, a year later or so, the discovery of positron by Anderson cleared up the situation. Thus, Dirac ended up by having predicted the positron. Vacuum polarization. As the vacuum has oppositely charged composites like any dielectric, it can also be polarized when a free charge is present. This creates a vacuum polarization in the effects of the field description, whose effects can be observed. Traveling in negative time direction. Feynman, two decades later, interpreted the negative energy of electrons traveling in the positive time direction as a positive energy electron traveling in the negative or backward direction of time. Thus, an electron interacting with a pair can be described as one electron traveling part of the time in forward time and part of the time in backward time, in backward direction in time. Fourier decomposition of the field into plane wave solutions. Next, we have to go on to quantization, and for this purpose, as done earlier, we decompose the field into plane wave solutions. We can write psi x as integral over d cubed p square root of 2 pi cubed into 2 ep summation over s equal to 1 and 2 fs function of momentum p into usp into exponential minus ipx plus gs dagger momentum P depends on, depending on momentum P, into Vs into IPX, where GS dagger P and FS P correspond to creation and annihilation operators. This implies destroying an electron of negative energy, and this corresponds to creating a positron of positive energy. Correspondingly, psi bar x is given as integral as d cubed p by under root of 2 pi cubed into 2 ep, summation over spins, fs dagger into us bar exponential ipx, gs into vs bar into exponential minus ipx. Total Hamiltonian can be written as, using the canonical expression for the Hamiltonian, as equal to integral over d cubed x, d delta delta psi dot of Lagrangian into psi dot alpha x minus L, which is equal to integral over d cubed x psi bar minus I gamma dot delta plus m operating on psi. We note that I gamma vector dot del vector plus m operating on us into exponential minus ipx is equal to gamma vector dot p vector plus m into operating into us and exponential minus ipx. So this is equal to gamma naught into ep into us operating on e minus ipx. Using the equation p slash minus m into us bar equal to zero, and the other equation p slash plus m into vs is equal to zero. Similarly, minus I gamma dot delta plus m operating on Vs into exponential IPX is equal to minus gamma naught into EP into Vs into exponential IPX. Substituting these in 6.2 and using U bar gamma naught is equal to U dagger and V bar gamma naught is equal to V dagger, we have the Hamiltonian in the form integral over d cubed x, denominator has 2 into 2 pi cubed, integral over d cubed prime, integral over d cubed p, square root of ep over ep prime, into fs dagger into us dagger into exponential ipx, gs prime into vs dagger into exponential minus ipx, multiplied by fs into us exponential minus ipx, minus gs dagger into vs exponential ipx. Using normalizations on u, v, u dagger and v dagger, we reduce this equation of Hamiltonian as integral over d cubed p into capital energy p, summation over s equal to 1 to fs dagger into fs minus gs into gs dagger. If the creation destruction operators commute, the second term will be minus 1 minus gs dagger gs, and the Hamiltonian gives negative eigenvalues. If, however, we assume fs and fs dagger and gs and gs dagger obey anti-commutation relation, equation 16, then the equation 16 has only positive eigenvalues. Normal ordering. We define normal ordering with creation operator on the left with anti-commutation and ignoring the one that occurs in the commutator. Thus, GSP GS dagger is equal to 1 minus GS dagger GS, and the normal ordered GS GS dagger is equal to minus GS dagger GS with no 1 on the right hand side. From equation 6.8, the normal ordered Hamiltonian will be integral over d cubed p into energy, capital energy for the momentum p, summed over both the spin states 1 and 2 of the expression fs dagger fs plus gs dagger gs. This is now positive definite and corresponds to the number of electrons and the number of positrons. In this module, we have learnt about projection operators for positive and negative energies, helicity, chirality and spin. We have understood the use of Pauli principle to tackle the problem of negative energy states, which leads to the Hole theory. We have learned to write the Lagrangian for the Dirac field. We have learned to Fourier decompose the Dirac field and quantize it. We understand that a Fermi field requires anti-commutation relation for quantization. We have learned that quantization takes one to a many-particle ground state or vacuum and by filling up all the negative energy states, the holes in negative energy states behave like antiparticles. Understand that particle-antiparticle pair creation in ground state or vacuum brings in a revolutionary new feature into quantum physics. Thank you.